coming on Friday. And then the clothes fall on. Cause it's just me.
Hello? Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here today in the sight of God, in the presence of these witnesses, to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God in the time of man's innocency, signifying unto us the mystical union that exists between Christ and his church. This holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence, and first miracle he wrought in Cana of Galilee, with St. Paul, who commended it as being honorable among all men. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these persons present now come to be joined. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? I would begin our ceremony this afternoon with that all-familiar scripture from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, beginning in verse 4. It gives us an accurate description of love. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. Love is not puffed up. Love does not behave rudely. It does not seek its own. Is not provoked, and thinks no evil. Love does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Noah and Molly, I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that the commitment to marriage is a commitment to permanence. It is the intent of God your marriage would be for life, and that only death will separate you. If the vows that you exchange today be kept without violation, and if you seek always to know and to do the will of God, your lives will be blessed. You'll be blessed with his presence, and you'll create a home and will abide in peace. Noah, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live? Molly, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live? Very good. Noah, would you repeat after me as I'm asking you to name your exchange? Just place that ring on the tip of the finger and hold it there for a moment. Repeat after me. I, Noah, take you, Molly, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and to that I pledge you my faith. I give you this ring as a token of my love, and as a pledge of my constant fidelity. Of my constant fidelity. You may place the ring. Do you have a ring? I'm Ollie, thank you, Noah, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge you my faith. I give you this ring as a token of my love, and as a pledge of my constant. Yeah. Let's bow together for a word of prayer, if we could. Dear Heavenly Father, we come here before you this evening. We acknowledge that you're our eternal God, you're our creator, and that you are the preserver of all mankind. We know that you're the giver of all spiritual grace, that you're the author of everlasting life. And my prayer is just now that you would send your blessing on Noah and Molly, your servants, this man and woman whom we all gather here this evening to bless in your name. We pray, Lord, that you would give them the strength and the power and the desire to perform and keep the vow and covenant that they've just made between them this hour. And my prayer is that they would forever remain in love and peace together as they serve you as Lord and Savior. Lord, we ask now in the name of Jesus that you put your blessings on their life together. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. For as much as this man and woman have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company and the family dog and have declared the same by the joining of hands, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife and dog, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and those whom God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Noah, I pronounce you husband and wife, and you may now kiss your bride. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Noah Sanders.
Thank you. Wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, yeah. Wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, yeah. Talking about, oh, I represent all 30s. is on the violin. Can't take to the time. People wish you for a fire. You can't have a mind. You know I just on the violin. For me, I'm a beat. Honey, why do you have a beat? I'm a beat. I'm a beat. Can't have a mind. God is on the violin.
The nation that greeted us. Why they don't never show me the love? Jesus shut up if I leave the spot. Walk the water while I feed the sharks. Everybody just got made alert. You might get killed on your way to work. Everyone seen it in broad day. Nobody filling that paperwork. Nobody cares if you made it worse. All of them talking, you made it worse. Timmy, Doom turned up. Got a burner, leave your block burned up. Like, look what you made me do. Look what you made me show. Don't ask me how you do it.
I'm Take it.
Slowly, slowly.
You still got time to go, ladies. You got something to go out there. We're waiting for you. We want to give everybody an opportunity.
I
want
to sing a
ladies. Are y'all excited about that bouquet?
Yeah. Y'all are my favorite officially. Peace.